am going to be connecting several different stories that have been buzzing around in the third page of your newspaper. Chinese tariffs, Brazilian forest fires, Italy without a prime minister, and a few other stories in this Marvel Cinematic Universe of news most Americans don't care about. That's right, I've pretty much created a digital version of a crazy person corkboard. I guess this is what happens when you give me a week without any juicy news stories. Well, tighten those straps on your tinfoil hats, everybody, and let's get right into it. We're starting with the story of retaliatory tariffs that China recently put on Made in America products.
Breaking news in the trade war with China. We are now learning Beijing will raise tariffs on $75 billion of U.S. products.
Now, China's really had a will-they-won't-they relationship with American soybeans since the trade war started. And this round of tariffs firmly put them in the won't-they category. Unfortunately, this is still quite the problem considering that soybeans are almost 10% of America's yearly exports to China? Wow, what a specific item to be shipping so much of. What can I say though, they love their soybeans. Now, this specific tariffs were an extra 5% tariff on American soybeans and crude oil imports, and the resumption of a suspended 25% duty on US cars. Now, this was not a shocking retaliation, and reports are that it won't have a large impact beyond shaking our confidence a little bit and further hurting our already struggling soybean farmers. Not sure if you remember, but earlier this year we bailed them out twice. The second time,
the U.S. Department of Agriculture announced an additional $16 billion in aid for farmers as the trade war between the U.S. and China carries on and tariffs stay in place.
Yeah, over the past year, the government has spent $28 billion buying excess agricultural products to prop up the price, because, hey, someone's gotta buy this stuff and China isn't. Point is, well, this is actually more than a ton of soybeans we're talking about here. Now, the question nobody's asking is, China can't suddenly start growing all these soybeans themselves, so where are they gonna source this from? Well, conveniently enough for China, there are plenty of soybean exporters out there. Here's a breakdown of the soybean exporters, and... hey, never mind! Wow! So it's either us or Brazil. More than half of our soybean exports go to China, so this would be a huge shift in the market. President Donald Trump is upset with China for buying Brazilian soybeans instead of American ones amid the ongoing trade war. So, okay, it sounds like they're replacing us. Boy, did they move on quickly. I'm a little bit hurt. But it also sounds like the market managed to reach some sort of equilibrium. Well, one problem. Total annual demand for soybeans in China exceeds Brazilian export capacity. In fact, it exceeds global export capacity excluding the United States crop. And this is why they're so hot and cold on American soy. China will say, we're not buying any more American soybeans. Wait, you're telling me the entire world sold out of soybeans? I kind of made a big deal about not buying them anymore. You sure you don't want to try meat? Oh, okay, sorry for being insensitive. I'll get Trump on the phone. Oh man, we are completely out. I should really get some extras to restock. And then the cycle continues. So now Brazil has a really good problem. There's so much demand for one of their major exports that they can't fulfill all of the orders anymore. Gee, if only there was a highly fertile piece of land somewhere in Brazil that wasn't currently being used for growing soybeans. Oh well, I guess we'll just be leaving this cash on the table then. Well, enter Jair Bolsonaro.
Brazilian officials have told the BBC that there's been an aggressive increase in deforestation since the election of President Bolsonaro in January. An area of Amazon rainforest roughly the size of a football pitch is now being cleared every minute.
Now, he's not clear-cutting the Amazon out of a visceral hatred for all things forested. And for this next part, I'm going to be working from Mongabe, a source I'm not familiar with, so I checked its media bias. And high rate of factual reporting with the same left-center bias that the New York Times has, I feel comfortable using it as a source. Now, they say that President Donald Trump's ongoing trade war with China has caused soy prices in Brazil to rise. Trace is linked to the trade war-induced spurt in soy production to 177 square miles of deforestation and 5.6 million tons of CO2 emissions. Whether or not this particular boom in soy production and deforestation will continue largely depends on how the US-China trade talks progress in 2019. I know I say I don't want to sound evil a lot on this show, but in this case, if you're a country like Brazil with persistent double-digit unemployment and the highest deficit you've posted in your country's history, well, you might also be tempted to tell Europe to mind their own business when you have such a lucrative opportunity staring you down in the face. But the environment. Hey, former colonizers, I'm just trying to sell some soybeans here to support my people. Now you can see this sentiment a lot in the interactions between Europe and Brazil. And before you hate me in the comments for mentioning any of this, well, I kinda think it's important to understand Brazil's perspective so that you know how to negotiate with them. I mean, don't worry, I'm gonna be talking about the other side of this argument a lot when I tie this all into Europe. So, demand for agricultural exports is driving deforestation. But I promised you a link to the fires, so let's follow this string of yarn a little longer. Now, there are two running theories for how these fires got started. First,
Christian Poirier of the nonprofit Amazon Watch. And he says these fires were started by
ranchers, land grabbers, and a range of other actors
who were emboldened by Bolsonaro's rhetoric. According to Poirier, they're setting fire to portions of the rainforest to acquire more land.
Oh man, the craziest part is he knew his mic was on and everything. Yes, the Brazilian president has, on the record, theorized that this is a conspiracy by environmentalist NGOs to destroy the environment. Yeah, it's a real Bush did 9/11 sort of conspiracy. He later said he had no evidence and walked back this claim, but there's still a suspect on his corkboard. Another theory that seems a little more likely to me is
Brazil, as part of the Mercosur trade bloc, just signed a big trade deal with the European Union, which is now concerned about what's going on in the Amazon. And we could see that actually having putting more pressure on Bolsonaro to have some more environmental friendly policies than any environmentalist could.
Now, to support this theory, in a not at all telling move, Bolsonaro has said he wants to convert this land for cattle pastures and soybean farms. So now let's zoom out again, because France is super angry about this huge expanse in Brazilian agriculture. Of course, this criticism hasn't exactly been heard loud and clear by Bolsonaro, because Bolsonaro has made clear that he considers the Amazon rainforest to be an issue of national sovereignty. He makes no secret of his resentment at what he deems to be foreign interference driven by a desire to hold back Brazilian agribusiness from competing in the international markets. Now, Europe does have one big trick up its sleeve right now.
Brazil, as part of the Mercosur trade bloc, just signed a big trade deal with the European Union, which is now concerned about what's going on in the Amazon. And we could see that actually having putting more pressure on Bolsonaro to have some more environmental friendly policies than any environmentalist could.
Yep, this episode is about to go full circle as the European Union might trigger a separate pro-environment trade war. French President Emmanuel Macron will oppose a trade deal, as it is, between the EU and South America's Mercosur bloc, which includes Brazil, because Brazil failed to meet its commitments to contain deforestation in the Amazon. The phrase fighting fire with fire has never felt so appropriate. You're motivated by trade, huh? Well, you can sell all the soybeans you want to China and export beef all over the world. But you'll lose out on our market, huh? So how's this gonna go down? Well, France actually has quite a bit of power, as the agreement can only enter into force if it wins the approval of all EU countries and passes a vote in the European Parliament. If there's not unanimous consent, this trade deal that's been 20 years in the making will be scrapped. 20 years? And I thought the USMCA negotiations were moving too slowly. Now, because of all this vested time and the economic interests, France is about to make the case to the world for why Brazil's treatment of the Amazon should be a deal breaker in this new deal as it's currently written. Well, fortunately for France and Macron, now is the perfect time to be frustrated, as there's currently a meeting that's very high profile and about to happen.
The United States, France, Italy, Great Britain, Japan, Germany, and Canada have since met as the G7.
This is where the European drama really kicks into high gear. The members of the summit are going to be negotiating the merits of pulling out of the deal, renegotiating the deal, or telling France to just chill out. Before we get into the different players in this debate, there's one pressing question that I haven't addressed yet. France, why are you so angry about all this deforestation going on in another country that you're willing to tank a 20-year deal? Well, this is a story so important that the slightly conservative magazine The Economist actually made it their cover story weeks before stories of these fires spread like, well, wildfire.
Our house is burning, literally, tweeted French President Emmanuel Macron. It is an international crisis. He's called on members of the G7 summit to discuss the Amazon fire at their upcoming meeting this weekend.
As he pointed out in that tweet, the Amazon rainforest, the lungs which produce 20% of our planet's oxygen, are on fire. Now, I'm no biologist, but I know that access to oxygen is pretty key to my continued survival. With the way things are going in Brazil right now, though, you might want to hold your breath. The other point that becomes very clear when you start looking into this is that the Amazon is unusual in that it recycles much of its own water. As the forest shrivels, less recycling takes place, and at a certain threshold, that causes more of the forest to wither so that, over a matter of decades, the process feeds on itself. Now, this is not something that you want to hear, especially when fires are a major problem. It also means that you can hit a critical amount of cutting, at which point nature will start doing the deforestation for you. Again, not great for people who like to breathe and environmentalists who are trying to get carbon dioxide out of the air. As they report, tree cover has accelerated by 2/3 since 2015. If it were a country, the shrinkage would make tropical rainforests the world's 3rd largest carbon dioxide emitter, after China and America. Armed with these facts, Macron is entering into this G7 meeting to try to get a renegotiation of this trade deal.
Pressure is mounting on EU leaders to act against deforestation in Brazil amid major fires in the region. Several MEPs are calling for the parliament to block the EU-Mercosur deal unless the government honors its environmental commitments.
What are those environmental commitments? Well, that's the part that people would like to see get a little more specific. As one European commissioner put it, we cannot sign this. We cannot approve this until Brazil gives guarantees to stop this deforestation, which is against the whole of the humanity. Interestingly enough, this worry is actually a huge defense of this trade deal. As the European Commission spokesperson Mina Adriva said,
the best tools that we have is the EU-Mercosur agreement, which for the first time anchors Brazil into the Paris Agreement. And it's actually the first trade agreement which contains binding commitments to effectively implement the Paris Accord as well as other multilateral environmental agreements. It's a way of working with Brazil and others to push and encourage each other to live up to the commitments we have made together in the Paris Agreement and work together on other environmental issues. And I think that there are also instruments with regards to the enforcement of these commitments.
Now, I read through this document because I know how to have a fun Saturday night. And what the agreed upon deal does mention deforestation. For example, a soy moratorium in Brazil to limit the expansion of soy plantations in forest land. Now, this would essentially be Europe saying, we're not buying soybeans that originated from recently burnt down portions of the Amazon. Those are the ones you have to sell to China. You gotta give us the ethical ones. Similarly, there would be commitments to not source meat from farms in recently deforested areas. Of course, the problem with all of this is it doesn't stop the deforestation. It only helps Europe sleep better at night. Now, there's also some talk of deforestation in their trade and sustainable development chapter, But whoo boy, is it just vague but very good sounding stuff. For example, their first idea, encourage trade in products from sustainably managed forests, harvest in accordance with the law of the country of harvest. Alright, I'll get right on that. It's this question of whether the current deal is enough to protect from deforestation that is motivating a hot new debate at the G7. Macron can kill this deal on his own, but he can't renegotiate it by himself. His goal is to get support behind a concrete push to protect the Amazon from the other major leaders. This first major leader he's meeting with is Donald Trump, and Trump has an opinion that surprised me a little bit. French officials conceded that there is no hope that Trump joins the group in expressing its concern about climate change, despite news that fires in the Amazon rainforest could accelerate the planet's environmental crisis. Yeah, they're not even trying to convince him to agree. Now, that probably doesn't surprise most of you, as he denies climate change on the regular. But, gee, I can't think of any other reason why America wouldn't want Brazil growing excess soybeans. I mean, this is one of those perfect storms for doing what politicians do best, and feigning concerns to help the American farmers. He's set in his ways. Then you have the United Kingdom and Germany, both saying leaving this trade deal is not a good way to deal with what's going on in Brazil. It will lessen influence rather than putting out the fires. Oh yeah, and I also forgot to mention, but this deal would be a huge boost to the German automotive industry. While Germany did support discussing this at the G7, Boris Johnson is against tampering with this trade deal, which led to some beautiful Boris Johnson quotes. My favorite one being, "There are all sorts of people who will take any excuse at all to interfere with trade and to frustrate trade deals, and I don't want to see that. Renegotiate an already agreed upon deal? Boris Johnson won't stand for that." Now Boris is just trying to not shake the boat as he's about to Brexit and will need to be making his own trade deals in a few months. Next, Italy. And well, they straight up just don't have a prime minister as of last Monday.
Our top story tonight, Italy's Prime Minister Giuseppe Conte has announced his resignation.
Because of this, most people are saying Macron seems to be relatively isolated on the issue. This leaves Canada's Justin Trudeau, who has jumped beside Macron to support this push. Although people who own maps will note that Canada, not in Europe. And Japan also has, by most accounts, just not stuck their neck out on this issue. They're a lot more concerned with the US-China trade war. And with that, we went full circle, back to the US-China trade war. Hope you enjoyed this picture I made from connecting all those dots. Yeah, it's pretty frustrating stuff. Moral of the story? If you're a country concerned about the Amazon, buy American soy. Trust me, we have more than enough to spare right now. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube! If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching!